people thought that $50 was an inflection point for oil. You know, oil is proving to be a much more challenging industry to figure out than that. You've both been active in energy. With oil where it is today, roughly speaking, $49, $50, what interests you?
Well, I think that, at least for us, we're still bargain hunters. We're still looking for situations that are less dependent on the problems of oil and more dependent on the problems of the producer. So I think that there's a lot more opportunity today in, frankly, grave dancing over leveraged players than betting that the price of oil is going to 60 or 40.
I would say the other issue and why we're sort of investing quite a bit in that sector right now is what you're seeing is the cost of extraction has actually gone down dramatically, and that technology
continues to
go down. So whereas in the Permian or in the Stack, where you had to have oil at 50 to end up, you know, breaking even, now that cost is probably 40 or mm-hmm. it's going down. So really what the opportunity is today, it's not trying to make a commodity bet. Really what you're trying to do,
as Sam says,
yeah, really what you're doing today is you're saying, hey, I'm going to deleverage these companies, and I now have the optionality that even if oil goes down to 30, I'm fine. I'm not making a commodity bet. What I'm doing is investing in a really good company that even if oil goes down, I'm going to do fine. But if oil stays where it is, I'm going to do exceptionally well. And to do that, what you're having happening today is this massive deleveraging that's going on. Because remember, everybody borrowed money when oil was at $100. Right? So oil,
they've been able to refinance some of that debt.
Yes, but what you're doing now is you're wiping out the unsecured, the sub debt, and you're wiping out a lot of that
debt. The junior parts of the capital stack.
And as you do that, that's how you're creating this value. So the real play in the energy sector today is on the restructuring side and playing at the top of the capital structure. Anybody plays at the bottom, they're making commodity bet, right? Because they're saying
that's implicit.
They have to, because that's the only way they're going to get paid.
Sure.
So where do you. You're looking for opportunities, over-levered companies, where?
In
shale country, principally?
In shale country. We bought a couple of refineries this year. Assets and that are energy-related, I think, are mispriced. I mean, when I was focused on real estate, the issue was replacement cost. When we're buying a refinery at 10 cents on the dollar, which is what's going on, or something like that, that creates a lot of optionality.
And you, Mark?
Same thing. I mean, look, we're investing in a couple of companies on the drilling, on a sort of
servicing
drilling
side.
Yeah, on the service side. Part of that is, you know, for these rigs, they ended up costing about $750 million when they were first built. If you look at companies today that are not levered, that are in that same industry, those rigs are going for around $450 to $500. So, you know, you've had a third of the value has gone away because of what's happened with oil prices. We're able to buy into companies that are being restructuring today. You're creating those same rigs around $200, $250 million. So you're creating them at a 50% discount. And the reason for that is you've got to do this huge restructuring. So I think you're getting massively overpaid right now to end up doing these restructurings.